Hey guys, Sudhir here with Nanavid for Blender. In this one, we're going to be talking about which version of Blender you should be using. So now, if you go to Blender website, right, you're going to be greeted with this download Blender kind of icon, and you can also download it in here. Now, this means that this is the current version, that's the most stable version that you can get. So if you download this version and install on your computer, it's going to be a default Blender. So when the Blender is gonna add an icon on your desktop, this version is gonna be launched. But it doesn't mean that you cannot use other versions of Blender, and I'll tell you why you should be using them. There are many advantages to this. To download other versions of Blender, right, let's go to download for a second, okay? And you see that in download page you get this main version here, but if you scroll down, you're gonna be able to download experimental. At the moment, experimental version is 3.0, which is basically alpha. Here we go, we got alpha version, which is the experimental. If you download this one, so simply click on that and you can download it. Now, this experimental version you do not install. Once you download it, you just simply move it to a drive of your choice and unzip it. You need to unpack it, so you can use, you know, Windows Zip or WinRAR or whatever the hell you're using, or for unpacking. Then you start Blender from that folder. You do not install it, okay? It's just simply a folder. I'm gonna show you how it looks, okay? So here you can see that on my C drive on a desktop, I have this version, Blender version 3.0, and you can see that that's the folder, the way you're gonna see this. Nothing has been installed, this is just an unpacked folder. And all you do to launch it, you simply double click the Blender icon, okay, Blender .exe file, and then you'll see that Blender is gonna get launched. Now the cool thing about it, which you can do, is simply right click on the icon and pin it or unpin it from the toolbar. And you can see on my toolbar I got four versions of Blender running. I got 2.91, 2.92, 2.93 and 3.0. okay, so now how the hell did I get 2.91 or 2.93? Well, that's easy. Okay, now to get the previous versions of Blender, you simply click on previous versions, right? And then you need to click on download every version of Blender, okay? And this will show you the list of literally every single Blender version that was released. Now, if you want to get 2.91, you simply click on 2.91 and you get 2.90, and you're getting all the versions that have been released under 2.90, okay? So you can get literally anything you want. And these versions, okay, they come in either a zip, so similar to the alpha version, or an MSI file, which basically is an installer. So you can either install it the way you were installing, you know, the current version, or simply just do the same thing as you do with the experimental version, which is, you know, just a folder and you do not install the file, okay? So that's how you do it. Now, the way to manage all these versions, simply you need to go to your C drive, user, your name on the computer, right? Then AppData, Roaming, Blender Foundation, and Blender. Now, if you can't see AppData, it means that you have some of the folders hidden, which means you need to go to View and simply check on hidden items, okay? So you can, you know, see them basically, all right? And then you'll be able to see that folder. And under Blender, you can see all the versions with all the preferences and all the config files in here. So if you want to uninstall something, okay, you want to get rid of Blender, you got some Python errors with add-ons, whatever, you need to purge your Blender, this is where you remove it. So after you remove the folder, let's say with 3.0, or you're going to uninstall 2.93 or 2.92, you also need to delete one of these folders, because these folders contain config data, okay, your startup file, config data, everything. So even if you uninstall Blender and you're gonna keep these folders on your computer, the uninstallation is not gonna be complete, because your Blender gonna be able to still access the previous data, all right? There you go, guys. Now, the advantages of using multiple Blenders. Now, first of all, you can have multiple versions installed. So for instance, if you're rendering animation, or you're rendering something that it's a bit heavy, you're gonna take, you know, a few minutes, 15 minutes, maybe animation is gonna take 2, 3, whatever hours, you can keep rendering in one Blender and you can work in another. That's one advantage. The cool thing about working in multiple versions is that, for example, you can click on an object, right click and copy objects, go to another Blender and Control V. You can copy as many items as you want, it doesn't matter, you can have a very complicated design, you can select everything, right click, then copy objects, go to another Blender, Control V, and you're done, right? So that's a really very fast way of moving items between Blender. Sometimes blend files get corrupted and you need to move the whole scene from one Blender to another. Well, that's your solution, because you know 2.9, 2.93, 92, 3.0, they all are compatible, so it's not a big problem, right? Another thing that, you know, I use multiple versions of Blender is for testing add-ons. Sometimes one add-on, you know, doesn't work in one Blender. I get conflicts, okay? I got different setups between different Blenders. In one Blender, the main version, so in this case 2.93, I'm gonna have all my add-ons, which is quite a lot. But let's say in 2.91 or 3.0, I'm gonna have specific add-ons, like just hard ups and box cutter, because I'm testing something, okay? So it's a really good way of testing, you know, testing your Blender. So these will be my reasons for running multiple versions of Blender. Like I said, you know, you should always run at least two, in my opinion. I usually run four, because you never know when you might need, you know, another Blender, okay? You know, you could work in one Blender, have another Blender open in another window, let's say when you're using something for reference. Alright guys, well that's it. These will be my reasons for using multiple versions of Blender. How to get them, how to install them, how to manage them. It's really easy. It's very quick to access them as well, because you don't have to go to folders. You simply keep them on a pin, pinned on the taskbar, and you know, you're good to go. So it's really quick and efficient. And like I said, this is the most important thing. Like sometimes I'm getting errors with add-ons and I need to keep working on something. I don't want to just spend an hour of trying to fix what's the problem. I simply move my file to a Blender which I know it's stable, and I'm going to continue working this, then come back and fix my problem, you know. So there's really no disadvantage to running multiple versions of Blender, and it's actually a great thing too, because you could check out new features of Blender, because alpha version like 3.0 is gonna come with, for example, the new cycles engine, right? So you can test this one, and if it doesn't work, you jump back to your 2.93 where you know things are stable. So this is a really nice way of working, very versatile, very fast, you know, and efficient. I hope it helps you out, guys. Thanks for watching. Catch you in the next video.